This is a creation with a plaster bust of my chest with a whole bunch of mirrors that have been kind of shattered and put on. It's capable to run up to 4 Raspberry Pis with MPI drops and whatnot running to play whatever video. Currently it's just on a color gradient to kind of give this ethereal atmospheric vibe. And another cool thing, because it can be kind of dizzying, you can just pause it with the click of a button. So this is kind of the kind of more tranquil, kind of calm vibe, I guess, to counter the chaos caused by the other one. So yeah, very much
great, fantastic. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. vibing here until then.
Okay, I'll see you then.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Miguel, and well, my piece is a pretty simple piece, well, with a simple title called Hide and Seek. And so the main point of this project is its computer has to hide away from you. And it's up to you, the player, the user, to find that computer. And so I think it's easier to explain as I'm doing it. So let's begin. It's loading, loading. So this idea just came because of our first class. I thought of a circle and a spotlight, and I'm like, oh wait, I can do something with this. And so the interface is pretty simple. It's all on the terminal of the computer. So it starts with, welcome to hide and seek. And it tells you how to play. You're playing against a computer. And this time around, you are the seeker. The computer will hide somewhere on the black screen. All you need to do is type in two numbers and they will work on a coordinate system. Finally, if at any point you want to quit, you can press Control C or just type Q at any prompt. So would you like to continue? And input yes. Now the computer is now hiding, and then the other three white screens just showing you that nobody's hiding there because it's blank and typically light. There's nowhere to hide other than in the dark space. And so now it tells you the computer's now hidden. It is time for level one. I need you to type in the coordinates slash area you believe the computer is in. I will take a number X from 0 to, in this case, it's 1,919. Now, I know that is very broad and it's a very wide, wide array of choices, but it's a little easier than you think. For example, I'm gonna type in 150, then it's gonna ask me for a y-axis, and I'm gonna type in, well, this time the y-axis from 0 to 1,079. See, not that bad, not that bad. But now I'll type in 500. Now I'll ask you, do you want to check in that area? And there's that little circle right there. And the computer is hitting somewhere in that single monitor. And so I'm going to type in yes, and it's red. That means the computer is not hidden in that spot. So now, but I did add something to make it easier because I did think it was very hard. So if your X value or Y value is within the computer's choice, it'll tell you, okay, your X value is in that area. So you're right. So now you just need to keep on checking where in the Y axis is it at. And so, in this case, my Y value was correct. So it is in the 500 coordinate area from up and down. Now, I wanna look where in the X axis is it at? So I'm gonna type in 1500. Now keep the 500, and then it's gonna ask me if I wanna check there, and I'm gonna say yes. And there it is. It intersects with the other computer, with the computer, and so it shows you, like, oh, you found it. And that was level one. So now it will ask you, well, do you want to continue to level two? And the answer is yes. So now you have to find it in these two screens. So your playing field has doubled. And then now it's from 0 to a low number of 3,839. So you know what? I'm gonna do 2,000. What could go wrong? But luckily, the y-axis is the same. So there's nothing to be afraid of, right? So once again, I'll do 500. It's right there. And then yes. The Y value, 500, is inside the computer's range. So I got lucky. It got to be in the same area. But now, where in the world is it in the whole horizontal area? So the way this works, since it's a set size, so I take about a ninth of the size of the screen, and the radius is a ninth of the screen. And so that means the diameter is double the ninth of the screen, so it's about this much. And so it has a wider area to look at. So despite the large number of numbers, since it's a much larger area you can look at, it's easier than it sounds. And so I developed the strategy of always checking like 1500, 2000, 2500, 500, and then just keep cutting it in half until I find the approximate area. So in this case, I tried 2000, didn't work, let's do 3000. Then keep the 500. It says, do I want to look? Yes. Still wrong, so let me switch to, let me overcorrect, 1500. And let's check 500, yes. And I found it.
Oh, wow.
Very slightly, but it is connecting to it. So you were able to find a computer. And I did forget to mention, but it does tell you how many attempts it took you to find it in this one level.
Oh, wow.
But it also keeps track of how many attempts you did throughout all the levels. So in this case, it took me 3 attempts, and the previous level took me 2. And then it tells you, you've taken a total of 5 attempts. And so now we'll continue to level 3. Can you guess what level 3 is? Well, now you have 3 screens to look for it. And the hardest, this one, this third screen was the hardest thing to implement because there's this blank spot where you can't look there. So I have to check, okay, where in the X value is the player looking at? Is it looking in this area or this area? If it's looking in this area, I have to limit them to that one screen. And if they're looking in this area, they can put in whatever they want. So in this case, we'll stick with good old 3000. And then since I have 3000, it's still telling me you have 1,079 areas you can check, technically. And so in this case, we'll stick with good old 500. No way it's 500 for a third time in a row. Yes. All right. So the Y value is in 500. And it is completely random. It is technically ran in a seed-based system, but I used a random number generator to generate a random seed. So it can remain consistent within all 4 clusters. And so in this case, since the wire is in 500 range, but just for the sake of testing, let's do 500 as the X value, and then 1,500 for the Y value. And it's right there. And so now, as I mentioned before, it asks you, do you want to check that area? And so in this case, I'm going to put no. So it stays there just to show you, okay, this is an area you looked at, you wanted to look at. And since you don't want to look at it, all right, let me show you what numbers you picked. And I'm going to keep it here so the player knows, okay, since I don't want to check here, I'm going to try to avoid this general area. And so in this case, I don't want to check there. I'm going to go back to the 500 area. And let me do 500, 500. Yes. And it's not hitting there. This is the only problem with testing. It's very hard to find where the computer is at. And in this case, I'm going to try to do it as fast as possible. I tried 3,500. Then 500. Yes. Come on. All right. No way it's 250. I'd be a little upset. Okay. Now I'm upset. I just couldn't find it. So 750. 500. It is a tough game. Oh, okay, I see what happened. I accidentally typed yes in So I did implement a error system, which makes sure if the player for some reason inputs anything random, it just says, come on, that's not a number. Put in something that is right. And it will just keep on telling until you give it a number that would work. In this case, yes. Oh, there we go. Okay. Found it. All right, it only took 10 attempts. Now, would I like to continue? Yes. Oh, it went screensaver mode. Oops, it's fine. So now we have all four screens for level 4. And as you can imagine, it's very hard. Someone just do the very center. And that's not the very center. 2000. This is, I tell you what your previous inputs were, like some sort of a list, so you don't have to try to always remember where have you checked. You can technically just look up, because it saves all your inputs, look up what you've already tried to input it, but I should make people's lives easier, including mine. And so in this case, 3000. Since it wasn't a ton, so 1,500. Yes. Oh, damn. Okay, so it's not 3,000. So we did 1,500. Then 500. It's also in 500. Okay, so it's not 1,500. I'm going to do 500. Yes. No. 500. Oh, we do 500. Then 3,500. Oh. Oh, whoops. 500. 3,000. Well, it's not where it is it looking at, so let's see, 2,500, and then 500, yes, and I found it!
Yo!
Alright, so it took 6 attempts to find it in level 4, and in total it took me 21 tries to figure out where in the world is it. But yeah, that's my project. So now, time to, just a quick check. I did update it as of like 30 minutes ago, and I allowed it for you, it to loop. So you can, it will ask you, would you like to continue playing? You can either say yes or no, and it'll bring you back to level 1. So we're about to find out if I messed up or not in coding it. So let's see, would you like to continue? Yes. It worked! But now let's quit, and should be done. And that's it. That's my project, hide and
seek. It's always a lot of fun when you have to wait all the way until the end. A very long process to debug the last little part. Yeah. Always fun. Thank you.
not even half of what I have. I like a good the hour of clicks. There it is. 7 minutes and 10 minutes. 7 movies in 10 minutes.
Thank you. Thank you. Columbiana County, a local southern train derailment.
There's a 1 mile evacuation zone.
The mistrust between residents and officials continues to get worse.
It's an almost apocalyptic scene. A freight train derails in a sleepy Ohio town, releasing thousands of gallons of hazardous chemicals and unleashing a toxic plume so large it can be seen for miles around. Thousands of people were evacuated.
It's the next phase of a punishing drought that has already ravaged the southwestern U.S.
This, I think, is the worst year we've ever had.
In Texas, two reservoirs of the Rio Grande are drying up.
Drought's going to be a huge issue in the U.S. in the coming decades because it's going to affect water supplies and it's going to affect growing food. And both of those are critical to our economy. And it's going to mean that we can't keep living the way we do.
Experts say climate change is reaching unprecedented levels.
Well, in 2020, during his campaign, when asked about his climate crisis plan, Biden did promise not to open up more federal lands to oil drilling. Take a listen.
No more subsidies for fossil fuel industry. No more drilling on federal lands. No more drilling, including offshore. No ability for the oil industry to continue to drill, period. Ends. Number one.